Hey, what is going on, guys? Calejandro here, and welcome back to another episode of Magayon. In this episode, we're going to be building a four-way intersection with a dedicated left and right turning lanes. So, in the last episode, I built the quote-unquote perfect interchange, which is, it's not actually the perfect interchange, I just use it for the title. It's a single-point urban interchange, which is an interchange with only one traffic light for those wishing to enter or exit into the freeway. So, the traffic going through the expressway is not obstructed. Anyways, getting back to what we're doing here, in this episode, I'm using the intersection marking tool, which is a very huge tool. It's what I'm going to be doing for the most part of this video, is I'm going to be doing line detailing and lane connections. So I can't do those diagonal lines using the intersection marking tools, as you can see that I'm placing there. So I just did the old-fashioned way of using those decals and also these lane markings, because they don't work, because I want it to be a little bit more customized, even though, you know, you don't need to do that, but, you know, you want to be a little bit extra. And I just found out that you can actually, in the new update of the intersection marking tool, you can actually place, instead of the just on the intersections, you can place lines on segments. And thank you, Rishav Dev, I think, for commenting on the last video, because I did that for this video and the next video, which is a roundabout build. I'm so excited. I actually split this episode into two. That's why it's 9.1, or episode 9 part 1, because the part 2 is the roundabout build and episode 10 is something a little bit bigger, so I think that's gonna take a little bit longer. So if you want to check out the interchange build, I mean the roundabout build, consider subscribing and turn on the notification bell so that you'd be notified whenever I upload a brand new video. Anyways, just did some basic lane connection there, and you know, with those lane, the lane on the leftmost going to the left and those two lanes going straight through. And I actually changed this traffic light setup, because I set it up, this is bad. So if you want to set up your traffic lights, turn on all the traffic signals turning right on each step, and then on each step all the directions for each side of the road will be turned on and then off for the next part of the road, off, on, and then you have like five steps. The first step, the four steps are for the traffic, and the fifth is for the people to cross the crossings. I don't know if that made sense. I hope that helped, because anyways, now I'm doing this detailing with these concrete pedestrian path assets, which have been a huge game changer for me, because without these assets, the path view builds that I've done in this series wouldn't have been possible, especially with terrain differences and such, because this is not like the concrete road, which, you know, when you change the surface of the area, it goes with it. This is like a separate thing. It's much better, but it has difficulty in, like, if your terrain is too steep or something, and when it's curved, you have to have like a perfect connection. So I'm separating that, because if I did like connect it to the roads, like to the paths that are straight, it has to be, you know, snapped using Move It. It doesn't, you know, it's messy. This is a very tricky asset, but if you learn how to use this, it's gonna help you in many ways, more than you could ever think of. So now I'm also using this grass plot asset, and I'm using that as a planter. I'm dividing those two sides so that this road, the pathway which is near the road, is for people who want to, you know, cross the street and just go about their day, and those paths on the inner side, farther away, separated by the planters, will be reserved for those who are going to the businesses, which I'll be placing in the episode 10. So if you want to check out episode 10, I see if you're excited for episode 10, consider subscribing, as I've said. And I'm just going to be adding a little bit of final details here and there, putting on the signs, which I forgot for the last episode, which I'll be putting here. And I think that's about it. I changed a little bit of the traffic light, as I've said, and this is a very simple build. So if you want to do this, you can even do this in vanilla, but just following the principles that I've stated, or might have not stated. Anyways, the video is coming to an end, so if you've enjoyed this video, consider giving it a big thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe. This is Alejandro, signing off.